I think it makes us different to a lot of companies. We're very closely tied to our dealer network worldwide. They are the backbone of our business, and really it's an interdependence, and without that sort of relationship, I don't think we would be the success we are today. And I do believe that.
Welcome to absolutely everybody in this room. We had some late arrivals last night. For the 250 of you in the audience this morning, thank you for getting here from abroad. And it's great to see you up here this morning. You know, I have lived all over North America, from Canada to the States, to Georgia, to Oklahoma, to California, and yes, right here in Las Vegas. Now, many of you have heard that slogan for Las Vegas: what happens here stays here. Well, generally, the slogan is better put: what's gambled here stays here. As Las Vegas performer and magician Penn Jillette of the group Penn & Teller once told me, and he performs at the Rio here in Las Vegas, for every dollar you gamble in Las Vegas, you might get 90 cents back, and the proprietor will tell you, you got a good deal. I have an idea that's somewhat similar, but every second and every dollar that you spend with JCB will get you a fabulous return. So let's begin the formal part of our proceedings today. First, let me welcome Sir Anthony Bamford and Lady Bamford on our front row here today. Thank you so much for coming in and being a part of what we're doing this morning. I know our audience appreciates you. Thank you. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the Managing Director and Group CEO of JCB, Mr. John Patterson.
Wow, what a crowd.
And now, I'm going to invite some of your colleagues to share with you how they have met these challenges. And Bob Losure is going to come back up here to interview them on your behalf. Bob.
Well, thank you very much, Matthew. You know, JCB has an amazing lineup of 290 machines. We've heard about the strength of the market in core products. We also know about the opportunities for growing your business. That means that you have to move beyond your traditional areas of strength. I'm talking about the volume opportunity that's represented by compact machines and the market value that's represented by heavy line. We're all aware that to achieve this, you will need new approaches. One dealer who has developed a highly successful heavy line business in Lanmati of Russia. And I would like to invite Lena Sokolova to share with you some of her experiences in developing this sector of the dealership. Well, good afternoon, Lena. Welcome to the audience. Audience, welcome to Lena. Well, you flew a long way to get here, all the way through New York, through Chicago, and on in here. Tell me a little bit about your dealership in European Russia. They want to find out.
Lanmati, that is the name of my company. And we have been JCB dealers since 1992.
Unbelievable. A fantastic growth record over there in Lanmati. I understand your core product is backhoe loaders, but you've also had success with several other products.
Yes, you're exactly right. Our core product was always backhoe loaders.
What about a couple of reasons why you have done so well in heavy line? What is it? And you've grown market share unbelievably.
We are a service and distribution company, and that is what we do.
Lena Sokolova, ladies and gentlemen, let's give her a hand for coming down. You know, I understand that Lanmati is not the only dealer who is making great strides in developing their business beyond backhoe. Let me give you some other examples. M3 in France, as well as Scott, JCB in Scotland, who's developed a strong excavator business, along with Durco in Chile, Cogemac in Italy, Interhandler in Poland, and Comasco in Israel. Well, now the last important JCB message is about investing in your business. We've all heard here today about the amazing success of the Indian market. It seems that the Indian dealers have used the good times to focus and to invest. Particularly impressive is Krishna Automobiles. And I'd like to invite down here to the podium Sachit Pasi to tell you more about it. Well, let me ask you, how is distribution changing in India in the construction industry?
In the last few years, India has seen rapid changes in the distribution standards.
You know, JCB India, I don't have to tell anyone in the audience, does have extremely high standards. How do you set the standards and how do you meet them?
Right from the beginning, we work very closely with the JCB dealer development team.
When I go into a nice restaurant, I always like it when I can see the cooks performing their job back there, when I can see everything being done. You've got that same kind of feel with a workshop, with the storage area, all available to see from the reception area. You must have planned it that way.
You know, Bob, when we sell machines, we actually sell a business, mm-hmm. and the customer buys a livelihood.
What was the rationale behind building all new headquarters?
Again, it's all about customer confidence.
Sachit, thank you so much. This wasn't so bad at all, was it, out here?
Thank you so much, Bob. Thanks.
Thank you. Sachit Pasi, thank you. You know, a lot of other dealers around the world have also discovered the value of investing in their dealership. Drawn to my attention are Sidema in Spain, Arnis in Italy, Lunmati, of course. They've invested $5 million in their depot in St. Petersburg. Nikolaisen and Larsen in Denmark with a $22 million Corona investment in a new workshop. Coamco in Panama. There at Coamco, they've invested $1 million in just improving their facilities alone. I'm now going to ask Matthew Taylor to come back up to the podium. He's going to come up and talk a little bit about the challenges which each of you will face in 2008.